kongelige højheder. Og sådan nogle kongelige højheder kom lige præcis forbi i dag. Den danske ambassade i Washington har været med til at udvælge 5. klassen her, som led i ambassadens indsats for at udbrede kendskabet til Danmark. Og det der er lykkes, i hvert fald sådan nogenlunde.
They ride bikes instead of cars. They created Legos, which I thought was weird because America created plastic. In Denmark, they don't really worry about stuff that's happening that's bad because they're always positive there, making Denmark a happier place.
You think so?
Yeah. When it came to the food, we gotta try it. Yeah.
What kind of food did you try?
We tried pickled fish herring. Yeah.
That sounds really gross.
Yeah.
What does it say on the sign up there?
It says, "Welcome, Your Royal Highnesses."
And how do you say it in Danish?
Welcome, there's kogosidin.
Not quite.
Not really sure.
Til gengæld er eleverne blevet ret gode til at synge på dansk. Den der om enebærbusken.
Nice.
Eleverne her i 5. klasse har studeret Danmark i et halvt år. De vidste ikke meget om vores land, da de begyndte. Og det gjorde kronprinsesse Mary heller ikke, da hun i sin tid kom til Danmark. Det afslørede hun i sin tale til eleverne.
One of the few Danish people that I had heard about as a child was the Danish author Hans Christian Andersen. As a child, his fairy tales caught my imagination. And they took me on exciting, funny and at times very scary adventures.
Resten af dagen står også i H.C. Andersens tegn. Senere i dag åbner kronprinsparet en udstilling med dronning Margrethes dekupager og kostymer fra filmen De Vilde Svaner.
Og i morgen skal kronprinsparet